Invasive mice are attacking birds and eating them alive. Let's talk about it, but before we do, fair warning, nature's pretty metal. And this story is about to prove it. Near Antarctica sits the isolated Marion Island, a biodiversity hotspot home to 2 million seabirds, along with a range of other species. Invasive house mice have turned this eco-haven into a gruesome nightmare. And again, fair warning, nature is metal. Scientists captured disturbing footage of the mice swarming albatross nests and attacking the chicks, slowly gnawing away at their flesh as they sat helplessly. Like I said, gruesome and not normal, but we'll get to that in a second. At this point, you might be asking, why don't the birds move, fight back, do something? That's the tricky thing about invasive species. Because they're not originally from the island, local wildlife hasn't developed any defense mechanisms to protect themselves. And that's not good for the albatross, currently classified as vulnerable by the IUCN.
The majority of the seabirds on Marion Island, about 19 of the 29 species, are considered to be at risk of local extinction in the presence of mice.
This is why conservationists hope to launch a massive eradication program to wipe out the brain-eating mice.
There is only one approach, one method that has been used to successfully eradicate mice and other rodents such as rats from these large islands.
Poison. Using up to 6 helicopters, they will drop up to 550 tons of poison bait across the island with the help of GPS tracking.
So that you can ensure that the entire island sown with bait so that you get rid of every single individual mouse.
The bait's been designed not to affect the soil or the island's water sources and won't have negative impacts on the environment. The project is also short about $25 million and still requires official approval, pushing the likely start date to sometime in 2027. I want to emphasize that the stakes here are high and there's almost no room for error, because if even one pregnant mouse survives, it could jeopardize the entire effort. The thing about mice is, they're very prolific. They can start popping out babies just 60 days after being born, and can have 4 or 5 litters a year, each with about 7 or 8 babies. So like, you do the math. And this isn't the first time that scientists have tried to control the mice on Marion. After hitching a ride on ships back in the 1800s, the rodents quickly took over the island. By the 1940s, officials realized this was a problem. Their solution was to ship over about 5 domestic cats for like a little Tom and Jerry action. And while the cats did eat the mice, they also ate everything else. Similar to mice, cats are also known for their reproductive abilities. By the 1970s, there were around 2,000 feral cats on the island, killing 500,000 seabirds per year. So officials launched a program to deal with the biggest problem, cats. Overall, it was successful, and by the 1990s, there were no felines to be found. You know what they say, when the cat's away, the mice will play? The population exploded, again. This time, surging to unprecedented levels, thanks in part to climate change. As temperatures warmed in the 2000s, more mice were able to survive the winter. They multiplied faster and faster, and food started running out, which is why the rodents have turned to attacking local wildlife. However, mice eating seabirds has only been recorded on a handful of islands around the world, but reports of it happening have gone up. And if the species they are attacking are allowed to be wiped out, the mice could go after other vulnerable animals.
We are very confident that eradicating the mice and removing that threat will result in a significant ecological and conservation benefit.